And the stream has begun.
Dun dun dun.
Okay. How's it going, Lurk?
Heyo.
So where we last left our heroes, we were on a desert island that was very hard to park on. We got a couple of chests that were somewhat annoying, and a dragon tried to murder us several times.
Succeeded once.
Succeeded. I think me. No. Twice he.
Yeah, it was just the once. It was almost twice.
It was almost twice.
Yeah, and like the depressing part about it is looking at that, Faye is one level away from being able to take the dragons.
Yeah, but it's fine. We got places to go and things to see. All right. So where's next on our adventure?
Okay, so we need to hit the hideouts, which is where is the hideout?
Well, hidden, presumably.
It should be the cave in the northwest.
All right, on my way.
Yeah, we need to go there, and we need to go back to Joe's.
The idea is that we are going to try to win the day today.
Hello.
Let's see. I slightly missed my dirt patch. There we go.
That's not the base. Where the hell is the base?
No. Oh, okay. I went in here for no reason.
I mean, it's called the Snowfield Hideout. I would assume it's on the snowfield.
Well, there must be more snow. Well, hi, bunny. How you doing?
Oh, is it the next? Is it the almost star-shaped one southeast of here? It might be.
All right, let's go find out.
It's Kreshava, but I can never remember where it actually came down at. Oh, that's Dave's.
Yeah, that's the big boy.
Oh, southern section of the islands, I think.
Does this map loop? Let's find out.
Yeah, it does.
All right, where on the southern islands? Is it the dot?
Yeah, it should be.
Okay. Yeah, it's definitely snowy down here, too.
Yeah, there we go.
Okay. Snowfield Hideout. It's screen wrapping Nova Drift. It turns out Nova Drift didn't invent screen wrapping. Not yet, anyway. I don't know what that means. Don't ask. All right. What are we doing here?
All right. First stop is going behind the gear seller, dude. Into the giant
room.
Oh, yeah,
because we got the sword.
Yep. Do you have Sidon? Send in your... go back and get Sidon. We need to take the kitchen sword off of his mech. That's what we bought the other sword for.
Which means we gotta go back into the ship, I think.
Yeah.
Into the sheep. And I think it's very likely that Sighton will be the final member of our endgame party anyway, so...
If you're going to take Emeralda out, make sure you take her speed shoes off.
She's fast enough without them.
I mean, she certainly can be.
Here, have a power ring.
There.
No pressure, but you're the only ones who can save us. How's it going, Lurk Scroll? There's a good chance you want a few set of Endgame parties. Yeah, that's what I've been told. But this is going to be like the final one. Let's see. The guy's upgrading his gear sword, not his personal sword. So
correct.
So I can just equip this, and that's fine, right?
Yep.
Okay. Let's see. Boom. Am I still keeping the trade card on him?
Can ditch that now, I believe. I'll keep an eye out in case we need to put it back on.
Okay. Then we go back, talk to the guy. Oh, I equipped his regular stuff. I didn't de-equip his gear, which was like the whole point of going into the menu in the first place, and just got distracted. Okay. So
I blame society.
So the Kenshin sword is the one we want off.
Yes.
So we're gonna put on this sword, which is worse. And then we're going to give him the other sword, which is better, but it's gonna be more better.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Okay, we don't have much time left. I said that last time, and you got into a whole dialogue.
That's just the first time.
Okay. Hop back down. Back in here. Primer Bunny isn't here. Time to party. She was here earlier. She poked her head in.
I believe they're star doing at the moment. So I expect we'll hear from her at the end of every day in the game.
Bunny's like, I'm here. Okay. There's been no interesting work. Forge me a weapon.
It's been an interesting work because you're only willing to work on one weapon upgrade. And all kinds of shit you can tinker with.
Oh, the Kenshin. You sure have a novel sword. We did take it off of a Voltron.
Mm-hmm.
It's interesting. Let me take a peek. Immediately takes a jackhammer to it. This came out great. It's like turning plowshares into a sword. I thought it was the other way around.
Details.
Use this sword and make Deuce and his legions pay. Kenshin sword was enhanced. Oh, they removed letters from it. It's just the Kaijin sword now.
It's true. And you should just do that right on.
So, it was a 10 power difference before. Now, it's a 90 power difference. Small upgrade.
Yeah.
Okay. How's it going?
Oh, Bunny, Romeo. You absolutely should. Core Keeper's great.
Romeo and Phoenix and Scott.
My wife.
In the last playthrough, you guys were on hard times. Everyone was so poor.
You know details. Now, the last thing... Check your inventory key items for a mermaid tier.
Let's see.
I don't think we got it, but if we did.
I don't see a mermaid tier in here.
Okay, yeah, then we don't need to do anything else here.
Okay. I'm fine.
Right.
Hi, I'm by Bluey Foxy.
Now to Joe's.
Dang, Joe. Okay.
To the lighthouse.
That was the... Like, I think on one of these little thingies like, on this island somewhere.
Like northeast of the of where Bebel Tower was? Somewhere around, it's to the west of where you are now.
To the west of where I am now.
Yeah, over by the old Shavat crater.
Was it on like a side island, or was it on like one of these big islands?
It's one of the tiny islands south of you.
Tiny island south of me, okay. Down here somewhere.
Angle a little more to the west.
No.
Your other west?
Well, that was my my west, right, but it wasn't west's west. And yes, Scott, I am playing the game as hard as it is to imagine, given the past several episodes of chair sitting. In fact, before every one of these streams, me and Firos send Xenogears gifts at each other, and today he sent me a rotating gif of the chair, and I was like, I thought I escaped it.
I've been holding that one in reserve for like a week and a half.
Get away from me with that damn chair. Okay, I think I can cut through this way. And cut right into a fight that I will run away from. How's it going, Machine Gwer? Is it this one right here?
I believe so.
This battle right here?
Fight says no.
Oh, hey, it's one of those dragons.
Oh, kick his ass.
Is he the same one? Does he count?
You can find out.
That did zero damage, because it missed, I think.
Yeah.
Well, so far, so good.
Huh. What's happening?
Can we hit it? Is it possible?
All right, Deathblow?
Yeah, that's what I'm going for. Okay.
You can run into these guys in here.
Hi, bye, Mr. Bearman.
Mr. Bearman!
Get out of here, you dang
dragon. I'm
wondering
if he's just going to be encountered here after you've met them in the desert. They have about the right amount of hit points.
A double dress.
Ah.
Is that good? Is that bad?
It's not one of their listed, but check it out. Those might be the same dragons.
Well, I don't think I can check it out, because we have an all-male party at the moment.
Fair.
Need the trader card? I don't know if it's...
I mean, if it just helps. I would throw it on while you're in here, just in case you run into more of those.
Alright.
Yeah, you can take off his normal armor. You can leave the speed shoes on.
But I'm scared.
You're in gears.
But I'm still scared. Cause I'm about to not be in a gear when I go into the door.
Hey, it'll be fine. See, everything good.
All right. What do we got today? We got an Alpha Nana.
Alpha Nana, yes.
A second book. A UFO photo.
I'm just giving those things away now.
And an eyeball. How exciting. Okay. Well, I know I have a new sword to sell.
Yes.
Thank you. Boop. Let's see. We have this gun, but we also have this gun.
Well, the Godfather stays. That's the like Billy's top gun.
Yeah, so this one is good to sell then?
The 686, I would assume so. That's an old one.
Yeah. Well, it's gone now. No takesies, backsies. Who's Joe? A jerkwad. And yet, I'm buying things from him, so really, what does that make me? Oh, Z-Charger, I can sell that for so much money.
I feel like it's a bad call.
AR-5s are old hats. Ether Arm 1s are kind of old hat, and they're worth a thousand.
Yeah, you've got 3s now.
I'm sure some of these could also be just taken out. I just don't know what. Oh, do you remember what the gold plate is? It's worth a lot.
Offhand, I don't. I don't think it comes into play in any major way, but...
Well, I'll hold it for now. Okay. So,
First thing, you'll want to buy parts. Once.
Because the chargers are going to be...
Yeah, this is going to be your biggest drop in one shot.
So we have one.
I would say at least one more.
Okay. Gold is anti-gel. Cast armor isn't any good. Okay, so.
Yeah, you can sell cast armor.
Yes, this is the very angry machine, but it costs lots of money.
It does. Okay, so you have the HP 30s. You've got two. Honestly, grab one more charger.
Okay.
And I think that's it for here.
Okay. That means we have 3.
Yeah, and then try to get the. At least the 90 armor on your 3 mains. If you can swing the Z gold on all 3, perfect.
I feel like I might as well. It's only an extra 1,500.
Yeah, you can.
Okay.
There's a frame for steer here.
He was still on 60s. I know there's a frame on him. I'm just gonna get all the armors done. Fenrir is the one I'm looking for, I believe. Yeah. A little tight. Let's see. You were right. I remember there being a frame for him. Giving him a bit more hit points.
As far as engine for steer and engine armor for Sighton, I think we want to go back to the Yggdrasil for that.
Yeah, these I'm sure are crazy good in the right circumstances, but I hate having that little amount of fuel. I hate it.
Yeah, it's dicey. I mean, there's ways to get around it. The biggest problem is that for most of the gears, if you're going to run those, you need to run frame HP 10s because you can't cast anything higher.
Yeah.
And it gets rough. Unfortunately, I think we are going to have to get a little bit of money, though, to finish upgrading from the YIG.
Well, get rid of the gold plate. Get rid of the caster arm, I think. Said.
You can ditch the pilot shield. You can ditch the power magics. Magnetic coats.
Omega 100 is worth it for Xenogears who sips fuel due to infinite mode. Yeah. I know that there's going to be situations where it's, like, incredibly good, but...
It also still comes down to the double-edged sword, because, like, yes, your output is crazy, but your healing is next to nothing.
Do I still need the seal barriers?
Keep the seal barriers. I don't... Because we are dealing with... We will be dealing with some seal stuff.
Plus one, so I don't know why they're just kicking around.
Noise filter can go.
The beam coats are old hat. Let's see. What about the veil doubler? I don't remember what that does.
You can ditch it.
Doubles veils, presumably. I think the insulated arms were also pretty old. So we'll do that. And then we already kind of did this. I think the Thor whip is the whip that Bart's waiting to put on.
I believe so.
Okay, so that puts us back at 32 and a half, roughly.
Okay, you got the armor and the Z-chargers here. Next up is back to the YIG to finish upgrading Steer and Fenrir as much as possible.
Okay.
Yeah, we might need to do a little bit of money grinding to get everyone else up to par, but we'll take a look. If we do, I know some good places to go.
So, what gets dropped for the...
The light armor. Pretty much across the board, because you'll be at 1,000 physical defense across the board, no matter what.
Okay. Let's see.
They'd be the extra armor in this case. I want to leave the ether on.
Now, do I want to give these guys the Z charges across the board, or do I want to save them for different group?
Throw them on for now.
Okay.
Phoenix Corekeeper Gray, I think it was up to 8 player.
Alrighty.
Dragon. Oh.
Pump the dragon. Dragon ball. Sad. Those guys are doing... not insignificant damage, considering I'm in giant robo mode. Also with, like, maxed out armor. Like, what are these guys?
Crazy. That's what they is.
That didn't work. That didn't work.
He doesn't have any attack magic.
Oh. Don't worry then. See?
Hey, it worked.
That was so they can all get away instead of just one person. It was calculated. Don't worry about it.
Sure. We can go with that.
Try not to think about it too much. Or at all. Okay. And... get out of the lighthouse... back at the ship. All right, where to next?
Into the ship. We're going to the gear hangar.
Can you give me directions?
past Margie's room.
Impossible. I can't go past there. There's a guy next to the door, and he looks like he wants to talk. He keeps giving me eye contact, and it's awkward. I don't want to go anywhere near him.
Well, because he remembers what happens in Vegas.
Oh, jeez. That's supposed to say in Vegas.
He didn't get that memo.
Oh, did the memo also say in Vegas?
Maybe.
Okay, so what am I getting here?
Any extraneous upgrades for steer and Fenrir. Possibly engine, frame for Fenrir for sure.
Let's see. Oh yeah, then that can go higher.
Double check engine too. I don't remember if they were at the top engine they possible or not. They're not.
No, not even close.
Oh. Oof. Okay. Yeah, we need some money.
That said, there is still some potential to liquidate some assets here. We just gotta go to the not gear store. So we can gotcha. go say hi to Mason real quick.
If you must.
Look, he's got nothing better to do. He's been cleaning that same glass in the bar for 12 years.
I'm just waiting for death.
Aren't we all? Here's the final hours approaching. Oh, can I get Mason in my party?
As a blade of armor, maybe.
Equip Thor and sell the whip too. Yeah, but that involves putting him in my party. Ugh. I can do it, but ugh. Tired of
finally time
at
to sell the
radish. Yes. Every dollar counts, and I'm tired of looking at it.
You can sell the Samson's hairs. You've never used them. Jerky can go.
Every dollar counts.
Bizfer can go.
Every dollar counts.
Steak. Stars can go. Bananas.
None of the scales.
We could take the scales to Kislev.
Yeah, but that's like a whole extra stop. The scales and the eyeballs.
Okay, now, before you sell the scales and the eyeballs, mm-hmm. If we do need to do a little bit of money grinding to finish these guys off, we're going to want to go to Kislev anyway.
But I don't so want just... to. I hate money grinding. I don't want
I know. You need at least this party of three to be fully kitted out. Because this place is a monster.
That's his old sword. Aren't theoretically some of these ammos old?
Yeah, but without seeing which guns he's actually got equipped.
And then there's also a gun here that I don't remember. Because I remember we didn't equip one of his guns to like hold for reasons.
I think it was actually the matchlock we were holding, because the matchlock fires elemental ammo.
Yeah, so. Fine, we'll continue to hold it. Oh, look how much we can get for the choo-choo idol.
I mean, you can sell it now.
Let's see. I feel like we got some stuff in here.
Power ring can go.
Probably one of my wizardry rings. I'm never going to use two.
Yeah. Yeah.
Let's see.
Power Crisis still safe.
Okay, fine. Hercules ring's pretty expensive.
Hercules ring gives you... That's XP increase.
It's just the XP increase? Get out of here. I don't need you.
Aether guards can go.
Out here scrapping together all the funds I can. Yeah, that's what it's all about. Do you remember what the starlight is?
Nope.
That means it's not good enough. There's that devil dress I got. You need levels to unlock moves? Do I need levels to unlock moves? Or do you just want me to? I don't know if I need to. Speedrun strats, baby. Let's see. The melee mantle is currently unequipped, but it is good.
Yeah, it's good. I'd keep it.
So... we got another Crimson Vest. That's old. Because the black leather, black helmet is like the baseline. And then we've been finding newer stuff. So let's try something like this. And then I'm gonna quickly throw Bart and Billy into the party just to assess their weapons and sell their old stuff.
Not a bad idea.
And then I might throw...
throw Choo Choo in to check out the devil dress. That's better than what she's currently wearing. That's one more thing we don't have to worry about.
Okay. Inventory management. That's a gear thing. The matchlock does seem to be better, but it is.
Yeah. So you have water and earth. So put on either air or fire.
Done.
Check his big gun too. His ammo for it. Did you just take the matchlock off?
I have no idea what I'm doing.
You did.
Yeah, okay.
And then the ammo for the big gun.
There we go. So something like that.
Yeah, that works. Then gears.
Thor Whip. Godfather. Godson ammo. And G100 ammo. Big gun. Alright. They are sorted.
Okay.
Change party members. Is that Rico from the hit movie Penguins of Madagascar? Yes. I don't know who will be able to wear this dress, so I'll put up two candidates just to see. Right, 'cause I got the beastly robe. Which, doesn't appear to be as good as other stuff that we have available already. Double dress is just strictly very much worse. Okay, good to know. Yeah, the executor gown is just like way better than that beastly robe. But see, black leather is like the baseline, so that'll give us an even better idea. Yeah, it's just worse than baseline. Got it. Okay. So, you know what? I will give you that. Unless you're the only one that can wear the beastly robe, in which case... No, she can wear the beastly robe. Or the golden vest. Yeah, okay. And now... Change parties for the last time in a small while. also, hi, bye, Arduin. I missed that earlier. Okay. Now we're going to go sell to the old man one last time, because we have a couple more things, and then we're going to go to the shop and sell a couple of things, and then see what we can buy with the new amount of money that we have. Because we can do at least one upgrade. Not one items. Weapons. We can get rid of this gun.
So all the B&J ammo then, too.
And 8 of that particular ammo.
We were getting that from drop enemy drops for a while.
Okay. This beastly robe is worth a lot and wasn't very good. Oh no, the beastly robe was okay. It was the devil one, the devil dress that was really bad. But the beastly robe wasn't that impressive either. It was So I think I get rid of the ammo.
Battle dress can go. I think the bodyguards can go. Etherstone large can go. Ruby helmet can go.
You said the ether veiler.
The veiler can go. The doubler you want to hold on to.
Okay. You said something else first that I didn't see.
You already got it.
Oh, I already got
the bodyguards.
Oh, the bodyguards.
Turbo double dress.
Okay. See, look at how much bank we're making. Okay. Alright. Bye, Mason. Alright, now get some upgrades. Just the X70s across the board, I think.
Mm-hmm.
See, look at that. Easy. And you're fine. Okay.
Check the engine on Xenogears.
Well, I'll do it from in here.
I was afraid of that.
He's got one of the new ones, but it's not the newest new one.
Alright, so we need enough money to get the engine on Xenogears, then I think we're good.
Mason, do you take an IOU? Lurk, just because things are good doesn't mean they're necessary.
Popcorn bun.
It's a very popcorn style game, particularly with all the cutscenes. do a quick little save since we did a bunch of stuff. Okay. Where to next?
If you want to just scrape together the money to finish off Xenogears, go to...
I'm going to make a bold claim. I'm going to say Xenogears is fine. Send us to save the world. I'm all right. Believe us.
In that case, make a backup save. Because once we go in, you're kind of stuck. So if we don't have the oomph, this is an easy way out.
Fine. Us being on the ground will be the backup save.
I mean, it is possible to get back out, but it may not be easy. All right, then we're just heading to Deuce.
No, we're not. You can give a second. Oh, that didn't do a lot of damage. But these guys also don't do a lot of damage, so it's really anyone's game. Let's see what this does. Damage.
Weird, right? Good old robot Jesus.
Now let's actually get on our ship. Okay.
Straight north.
To the dot. Yeah, to the big angry that sits in the middle of this island.
That'd be him.
Do we just fly into him? Do we have to land and walk into him?
Just fly into him, I think.
Oops.
Or the other thing.
No. I tried walking into him. The game said no. We do have speed shoes on our party members. And do I want the duration doubler on Faye? I don't think so.
You can game the system, but it's not necessary. The 2x support time item that Billy came with, you can put that on Faye, and his Infinity Blood lasts 6 turns instead of 3.
Ah. The mapping of the inside of Deuce is now complete. Alright, let's go, everyone! Okay. We can go forward or backward, theoretically.
Okay, this one's gonna be mostly relying on map information.
Okay.
So, head north until the Y. Then take a right.
Into the fight.
Yeah, caution, this place hurts.
But they are ether-based attacks, so I'm wondering if,
Already got ether armors on.
Yeah, but there could always be more ether. These guys also had negative hit points themselves.
Well, the problem with putting more armor on is that you lose the charger and the the heal.
Yeah.
Both of those are better anyway. All right, stick east.
Okay.
Stick east again.
Dead end?
Oh, good, there's cliffs. These aren't on the map. Awesome. Okay. go back around to where you saw the laser thing. We have to get past that.
I like how before we hit that cliff, will Fifi get confused again in this map reading? Yes.
I read the map fine. The map just didn't show that cliff.
Fuel leak. Does that just mean that I'll lose a set amount of fuel, or that things cost more fuel, or...?
You lose percentage base at the end of your turn. It's not much, and you've got the Z-Charger, so it really doesn't matter.
Okay. You're supposed to die there. There you go. There's a good lad. I like how they're doing all of these status effects, but they're not actually hitting me. Also, I should have just...
Yeah, some of the enemies in here are gimmicky.
I'm like, I should just death blow you, and then I hit all of the wrong buttons to not do it.
Oh boy.
It was a show of power. He died anyway. Okay, so here's the laser area. Do I just gotta like play hopscotch with this thing, or?
Essentially. JK.
The floor is lava, if lava is another gear. Bonk. I don't like it when you use beam attacks. You should not do that.
Okay, he'll stop. Jeez.
But I had to take corrective action. Now he'll never do it again. Mirror armor. Don't have that yet. That's new. In fact, I'm gonna go take a quick peek just because it sounds neat. This might not be good.
I think it's 100% reduction on beam.
50%.
Probably 50. All right.
But otherwise, pretty whatever.
All right.
We got another fork in the road.
Yep, head east.
We got another fork in the road.
Should be southeast after this fight.
Yeah, I feel like if I take a right again, that will be like at the top of the clip I was at the bottom of earlier.
That's essentially where we're going.
Block that one.
I forgot how damn fast these guys were.
They're fast, but they don't do any damage. They're just kind of annoying.
They don't. They're just annoying. But, like, they're going one-to-one on you, and you're boosted.
Yeah. They're a bit quick on the draw. Alright, so which way did you say?
Southeast.
Okay.
And then northeast.
Did you say southeast and then fight? Oh, these beam guys again.
You can heal with impunity, remember?
I know, but they're just annoying. Do I have repels? If they were Pokemon, maybe the repels I had in my back pocket would work. Bunch of light armors.
Yeah, light armor threes, though. They're actually pretty good.
Yeah, they're certainly usable. Ooh, I jumped too early. Oh, but it was fine.
Still missed you.
Okay.
And then if this should be northwest.
Oh, you're...
Oh, wait a second.
You're new?
It was Sighton. Mm-hmm. I think these are the guys. If these are the guys I think they are.
Yeah.
Do it. Yeah. Hit light attack with Sighton. Nope, these are not the ones I thought they were. Go ham. There's one enemy in here. They're called Heal Seraphs. And when you hit them, they apply either healing or fuel restore to whoever hit them.
Oh, that's nice of them. Angel armor.
Angel armor is good.
I'm finding new and spectacular thing. Well, potentially spectacular. I don't know. Gear.
I don't think we need it yet, but Angel Armor is pretty good.
I'll just take a peek at it here. Angel damage down 30%. 50 defense. Interesting. What?
I think we'll want that for some boss fights.
I think he said northwest.
Yes. To be the exit.
I didn't know angels had their own type of damage. Okay.
Alright, now where the fuck are we?
Well, the camera is locked to this position or this position. And it looks like I either go down or some crazy parkour. Maybe I can jump up those sides, but those jumps seem a little bit too jumpy for me.
I believe we're going down.
Ah! Oh. Oh, you didn't tell me I had to dodge laser beams. Oh, jeez.
Oh, it's fine. You got this. Just remember your super shark training back in the day.
It's not even... Oh, jeez. This is weird. It's spinning. I'm just gonna... Would you just... Yeah.
Okay.
Made it.
Time for fun.
Okay. So do we just go down the obvious path, or can we jump down to that path, or...
Obvious path from here.
Okay.
This place is kind of a big-ass puzzle. So this is going to take some work.
Faye, look at that. May be able to get to a lower floor through that gate. Okay. Do I have to make that jump, though?
No. Coming down here is just to get the visual and kind of the idea of what you're going for.
Oh. So I don't jump there.
Correct. And you go back to the platform and hit the elevator.
Oh, yeah, that makes sense. Titan? No, there you go.
Right. At the first split coming up, go southeast.
Am I going straight up this way?
Yeah. I ride the elevator up and go southeast.
Yeah, I was going to say, I don't think I have a choice in that particular matter. Elevator again, or do I go this way?
Elevator up. This elevator goes up, and yeah, so go up and hit that switch.
No, this elevator goes down.
Can you jump to the switch?
Is that the switch up there?
Yeah. Oh yeah, yeah. You should be able to jump up.
Okay.
It's a push. Should be a push. Why are you not pushing?
Oh.
There we go.
Some things are shove your face into it to push. That one was a press a button to push.
All right. Now we're taking the elevator down.
Whee. Okay.
This should be a one-way street all the way up to another switch like that.
Another elevator?
Yeah. You'll be going up and down a lot in here, Katie.
Satan doesn't know how to get into elevators. He struggles. no switch up there yet. So...
You have to go...
Go down over this way. No switch up there either.
Up, down again. Switch should be on the next one.
Go up, go down. Oh, you're getting bonked. You can't bonk him this early. He's my map reader. If you bonk him too early, I'll never get out of here. Oh, that's less of a switch and more of a beam. Oh, there's a lot
we'll
of
need
that,
that later.
If that, well, if there's a lot of that going on, then ugh. Elevator?
I don't think you can use this one.
I cannot use this one.
Yeah, we're heading back now, back to Switch One.
Everything here looks so samey. You'll have to tell me what Switch One was. Titan, get in the elevator. Learn how to pathfind.
Oh, this place is gonna, it's gonna hurt our heads before we're done here.
Is it helpful to state that right before the stream I had a pretty severe headache?
Oh, this is the best place for you then.
I took some Excedrin and it's kicking in now. I'm feeling okay now, but before the stream started, I was like, oh god.
This is good. I think we leave Switch One for now.
Which direction? There's two ways out, it looks like. Southern path.
We're heading
northwesterly path.
Hold on.
Holding. Looking at
this. This is fucking stupid. Okay. We might need to switch the thing around again.
Hit the switch again.
I can't tell. Leave it for now. Okay. We're heading back northwest from the switch.
Northwest from the switch.
Then across, we're heading southwest.
Okay. And then we got elevator or southeast?
Southeast.
Oh, this is a bendy bridge. This is new. Hey, a door. Okay.
Take the first east you can.
Oh, look, it's an angel robot. Cute. Not gonna lie, I felt a little bad about that. I don't know why.
Oh, okay. Those are the ones you want to hit with light attacks.
I thought that might have been the case, but I was
I wasn't sure, but I thought too as well.
I was like, he didn't say anything, and he thought that the other things might have been it that looked very different. So I'm just going to assume it's not. Okay, we're going through a thing here. All right.
North.
Ah, back to this again. Well, I guess we're going to the elevator because there's literally nothing else to do. Except, I'm not.
Treasure chest north side.
Oh, wow, that thing is tiny. Didn't even notice it.
And this is all we're here for.
Oh, it's just ammo. Okay.
Alright, now we're heading south. Until we get to the second west. This would be the second west.
Yeah, okay.
It'll take the first break off of this path.
Before I could break off the path, my screen broke. Alright, so these guys also have halos, but they look different than the friend bot.
There's a lot of Seraph enemies. I don't know which one's which.
As always,
we have violence. Wind, fire, power, heal, and earth.
These are the fire guys. Did he just kick me in the shins?
He did.
Ether arms. Oh, the cat motor's on. Oh, I moved 2 feet. We just fought you guys. Get out of here. Oh, that did like no damage. That did literally no damage. Why am I not doing any damage to that guy? Does this game have a back row mechanic that I'm not anticipating?
Not that I'm aware of. The spider.
Ooh.
Yeah. Oh, about that heal.
Loading on so many Aether Arm 3s.
Oh, yeah.
All right. Back to the bridges.
Gear first. Should be left up here. After elevator.
So don't take that path?
Not yet. Okay. We'll be back to that.
Sight, and one day you'll learn how to elevator.
This is not that day.
What a glorious day it'll be, though. Alright. We got another elevator situation.
That should be a switch on top.
Yeah, it is a switch on top. Alright. That guy is spinning away from us.
Yep. Okay, now we're backtracking.
You're so close.
Now we take the southwest.
Okay. Hop up in here. Looks like we
have. Hey, he made it.
For once. All right, we got two directions here. Northeast and southwest. Or northeast or just south, actually.
Not south. Oh, wait. This is not map, you're dumb. take the south, I guess.
Okay.
Does it do another switch?
Yes, it does.
Good.
Burp.
Now, this goes back to where we came in at.
Okay. Do I want to elevate then?
Yes.
Okay. This is my only path, at least a door. Those thingies, and we got a fight, and then we got a split path. Earth Seraph was faster than me, which means that I don't have to decide whether he's good or bad. I just know that he is.
Yes.
You stop hitting him. Oh, that hurt. Ooh. A lot.
Ouch.
Alternatively, that didn't hurt enough. Hmm. Okay, then. Got Angel Arm plus one, though. That's something. Okay.
Should be here, so you're going north. At the T, you'll take a left.
Nothing like a very, very long, windy hallway to make sure that I get into many more fights. Oh, this is the friendo fight.
You can charge. You should be able to fuel charge on this guy pretty safely. Didn't realize he had attacks. He wasn't sighting this time. Probably have sight and do light attacks. Just have everybody do light attacks.
I really wanted sight to get his fuel up.
The attack will do either health or fuel.
Okay. Well, one attack too far. All right, left of the fork. Yeah, that amount of healing wasn't great, but...
It's not much on healing, but when it hits the fuel, it's huge. Because it does 1,800 of either.
You're new. I still want Satan to charge.
There'll be a shot bot before too long.
Oh, okay. Well... so thick. Didn't even have the dignity of attacking me with your weapon. That did nothing. Block.
Can these guys leave Satan alone for like a minute?
And so they did. So thick.
Yeah, these guys are a bit of a problem.
Okay, we got there.
Huge XP though.
I'll take it. Anti-angel system.
I have no idea what that is.
It's a system that's anti-angels, precisely. Thank you, I'll be here all week. Angel damage down to 100%. Huh.
That's big.
I mean... Do I give up Aether Defense for just being immune to these guys for at least a while?
I wouldn't yet.
I'm streaming tomorrow, says who?
Man, that sounds like a joke I'd make, but I didn't even make it.
I said? When did I say that? I am definitively not streaming tomorrow. Gonna be here all week? Yeah, but I only count the weekdays. And as it's Friday, that means that you only got me for another, 3 hours or so. Just for the week. Then I'll be back. Okay, there's no extra path going off this way.
Yeah, this should be a one-way trip.
And here's that hole.
Get in there, you big furry oaf.
Time to go.
I don't care what you smell.
Whee! And so he just walks on top. Oh god, more of this! I wasn't warned.
Surprise!
Ow, I got hit once. I don't know how detrimental that is. I got hit twice. Because the camera just spins whichever way it wants without any input from me.
Well, we've seen this before, but it's been a minute.
Hi, Sephiroth. Hi, Lady Sephiroth.
So, which one is David Lee Roth?
Yes.
One that looks like a gigolo.
Everywhere I go.
Don't ask Eddie Van Halen.
That's probably fair.
Okay, so we got a door, we got a save, we got a party switchery-roo. Okay. So we can save on this one because that one is our things have gone horribly wrong thing. Okay, so it looks like we have a door and the way that we had to go to fight Ramses that one time. So, theoretically, this should be the shop person. If things are as they were before.
This part should be the same, yeah.
Like this shaft connects to the outside. We can probably get out through here. What would you like? So we could leave. We could leave out here.
You can leave from here. Yep.
So I didn't need no safety save. This slot's a safety save.
It is now. Had to get here alive first.
Ah, easy peasy. Okay. Gear. Let's see.
Ooh, see if this guy has the new engines. He does. Nice.
So there you go. I can get him the new engine right here.
Done.
No grinding required.
And then just fuel up and should be good here.
Lovely. I'll save again with that done. All right, and it looks like we're ready to rock and roll here.
Yep, just point of no return kind of thing. Almost.
The point of almost no return sounds a little less ominous.
I believe that was the last save point.
Okay.
We're real close, Sog.
The idea was to hit it today.
Nope.
Hey, I remember that hole. I punched that that trash man through it.
That's just rude.
And this is where God was at one point. Do you want to jump inside? Heck yeah, I do. I want nothing more.
Woo, hot tub!
Sploosh.
Oh, it sounded like Campbell's primordial soup. What the hell?
This is Deuce.
Woohoo, drug trip.
What are those four orbs spinning around it? Seems as if the power of those four things is supporting the center. We'll have to split up into four groups. I'm presuming. The big thing in the middle is the core of Deuce. Yeah, probably. Like, I was just like, I don't know. Cares about those ores, let's just crush the core. Trading directly at the center rather than using fuel unnecessarily. That is one strategy, but I believe another plan of attack would be to defeat the surroundings first. If we decide to attack the supporting orbs first, then it might be wise to leave the battles up to us. We should be able to do something about them without using up phase power. Not allowed to use the full power of the Xeno Gears roll credits to defeat Deuce. And of course, to save Ellie. Well, one way or the other. Whether we do a direct strike to the core or take down the supports first, I guess that's best left up to Faye to decide. Oh, so it's a decision.
Yeah, so there's a few ways to do this. You can go right for Deuce. For the hardest possible boss fight.
Yeah.
You can take out the spheres. Each sphere destroyed seals one of Deuce's abilities. In addition, you've got the party switch right here.
Yeah.
You can sub other people in to take out surrounding spheres to save your main party for Deuce if you want.
But I theoretically, can I do all of the fights with the same team if I wanted to?
Since you're running Z-charges and HP-30s, you can do the one team for everything.
Alright. Well, I think I would... I'd prefer to just keep this party and then rock and roll with it as much as I can, and then if that turns out to be a bad decision, I got a save file, so that's fine.
Mm-hmm.
So how do we choose which one we do?
You don't. You just walk into one. They're rotating, so whichever one... Once you kill one, I can figure out who's left.
Well, they're rotating, but I don't have... I guess I'm gaining some height. Oh. Okay. That was weird.
Alright, who we got? Sundell.
Targeting counter-attack target.
Alright, okay, give me a sec.
If he's got counter-attacks, then this is gonna be a little spicy.
Who did he target?
Robo-Jesus.
Okay, then do not attack him with Robo-Jesus right now.
Okay.
Other than that, this guy's not too bad. Just don't attack with whoever's targeted.
It seems reasonable enough. Was that just an attack, or does he counter any attack by hitting?
It looks like it's the entire fight.
Okay. Great. Ooh, that was a big hit. So yeah, any time anyone hits him,
you can have Faye just defend if you want,
which is what I do.
Yeah, or you can go mental and just try to heal up before he dies.
The blocking strategy I don't hate.
It's not bad.
I'm almost wondering if I pop up his defense and then just be like, look, I'm tanking.
You can, yeah.
Look, I never use this power. and yes, Phoenix, there's no more Coke Zero and seeing Great Days Under the Gallery because I finished it.
It's actually kind of a shame that you got this one first, because of the four bosses, this is the best one to heal up and recharge on.
Eh, alas. Zero damage.
Zero. All right.
Does that mean that his defense is just high enough where he doesn't care anymore?
For the counterattack, maybe. Yeah. Kind of looks like it.
Does that mean he can attack with impunity?
Give it a shot.
Oh. That one, he counterattacked everybody.
Yeah.
All right, sealed deuces healing. That seems like a good seal.
Yes.
All right, that one was not bad at all.
So,
XP one.
Yeah, then whatever drops, blah blah whatever. Okay, so counterclockwise is Metatron, clockwise is Marloot. From where
I where ducked that one just in case.
Okay, you just ducked Marloot.
You know what? I'll go.
That should be Harloot. If this pattern is written down properly, this should be Harloot.
It is Harloot.
Okay.
Space time move one at a Tim.
So that is a global stop except on the person targeted.
So what you're saying is it's Rico time.
It is only Rico time.
It was always Rico time. He's waited his whole life for this moment.
Taking out Harloot seals the Heaven Anointment technique.
Rico going kind of ham, though. Oh. Ooh. A little painful. I think I might want to do a round of healing.
It's not a horrible idea. Like, Rico's still probably okay. But yeah, the other two healing, not a bad call.
I'm going to have Rico heal just because I don't know how much hit points this thing has, and if I kill him before
they
can heal, that would be sad. So, do you think he's got enough? He's got
plenty.
Enough tank? Oh, okay.
Yeah, plenty.
Look, I don't underestimate Rico and his power of murder. Like the meta of this game is really level one death blows unless you're going for infinite mode.
Yeah, I mean, for the most part on Faye, it's better to go infinite just because he's so easy to get into it.
Yeah.
Like, you build it to level three, you ramp your attack, and then go ham for three turns.
Slow. Okay.
Well played, I guess. Blowing a dude that stopped. Nice.
Oh my God, I'm not gonna argue. I'm just gonna smile and nod. Oh, there we go. Done.
All right.
Rico making it work. All right. I think I'll just stay here and let the next one spin into me then.
That works.
Hello, friend. For a second, I thought he was going to miss me.
Marloot?
We'll not be able to confirm immediately, but definitely looks interesting. Nope.
Metatron. Okay. He's going to do fuel drains. Wait, Metatron.
Ooh, he did a big earthly anointment. That's what he did.
Yeah, that's the one that is really good to seal off. He can hurt.
Yeah.
He's not hard to kill, but he's got good output.
I think I'll try to kill this guy quickly and then heal on the last one, maybe.
Yeah, the last one should be rechargeable on. If he does a defense down, you want to cure it before his next turn. Next turn. That's his only real gimmick.
Okay.
But with all three of you going, this guy should not last very long.
He does have more defense than the other guy.
Yeah.
I don't know if he also has as many hit points or less or more.
About the same.
Okay, so.
Maybe. All right, while you finish this guy, I'm going to get a drink. I'll be right back.
Okay. Ouchie. Gonna try my best not to heal here, and then heal in the next fight. We'll see how that goes. Big swing and a miss. You really don't like sighting at all, do you? Him. You can take it.
I see Satan's having a good day.
It just every time there's a single attack, he's just like, but what about this guy over here? Satan, you just have such a punchable face.
He kind of does, though. That goofy ass chin, the smug look.
Would you stop? I really want to get away with you not healing, but it's now getting into the territory.
I would heal.
Yeah, I'm a heal.
Might be worth letting Faye charge up to infinite on this guy.
I mean, this deep into the fight?
Yeah, this deep, probably not.
I was gonna say, based on the amount of hit points you say he probably has, he's very close to dead. Oh, stop bonking. Just quit it. Stop it.
He's rocking.
There we go.
Nice.
Okay, so now Operation Make Fuel and Hit Points go up for this next fight.
So the shitty part is that one of Marloot's attacks is an AoE fuel drain.
Ooh.
But with Z charges, it's not like it drains 330 to 350. You charge 500.
Do I charge 500? I think I charge 200.
No, the Z does.
Does Z do 5?
It does either 3 or 5. I think it's 5.
I don't think it was 5. I think 5 sounds too high. Morph. Fuel drain. Oh, you drained 400.
Good, 4. Gross.
Theoretically, we can try to get people into infinite and then super fuel.
You can try, yeah. Get them up to level 3 and then just start just charge every turn.
Well, getting him into hyper mode seems to be much easier than the rest for reasons.
Yes. I mean, everyone's low enough that it... The hypercharge chances aren't bad. Now, Marloot does have one big-ass attack that'll hit for 5, 6, 7 thou on everybody, but it's okay. The least used attack.
More fuel drain. Okay, so this one's gotta be X.
No, it doesn't have to be an X. You can do any attack.
Well, doesn't that go into the death stuff? I mean, I can hit circle, I guess. Yeah.
Yeah, you can always cancel out.
Something about that wobbly noise that it makes. It's like I made the joke that it was a format, and I think it really was. Also, damn, that did a lot of damage.
Yeah, Marloot has crazy low defense.
Okay.
And now just start charging.
15%. Like, I really want Sighton to get it.
Mm-hmm. He needs the most low right now. But you're 4210. 4770.
Okay, so he's in the juice.
Do a heal this turn, then charge next turn.
What happens when you heal in this mode? Does it heal for more?
The heal is the same, but your charge will put you at full health, full fuel.
Come on, 15%. Rico's went off.
I do the same thing, then heal then charge.
Alright.
Hey look, tons of fuel.
Alright, Sidon, I need you to hit that 15%. Rico's full of fuel. Do I just...
You can get away with an attack.
Ooh, haven't seen this one. Did it do anything?
They got blocked. Heavily.
I really need you to do the thing.
Since you didn't do since you didn't do shit with Faye, go ahead and unload here. Or just punch
or don't.
I guess. Oh, that's right. You can't deathpool them. That I forgot about that.
Hey,
Satan. About fucking time, buddy.
Good news, everyone.
All right. One more charge on Satan, and you should be ready to just start stomping. Just river dance this man into oblivion. Oh, there's the big boom.
That was...
That did way more than it should have. What the hell?
That was a lot of damage. Well, there goes my fuel reserves.
You're still in pretty good shape. With all four defeated, Deus is actually is not bad. A lot of shit, but...
I think I heal again and then just charge for the third turn, then.
Yeah, I would. Damn, Satan, nice fuel.
Hopefully he doesn't die, but I'm going to take swing so I'm not wasting my time here.
Oh, you're fine.
All right. How's it going, Shin Jack?
Hey, buddy.
Stop wobbling at me.
You're probably better off with square attacks just because they have less chance to be blocked.
Stop it. Guys, it's a bully. Right, keep stabbing. Okay. What are my upper hit point levels here?
He caps at 30,000.
So, I probably have time for a boost charge or a heal charge.
Oh, absolutely. Sorry, 34.
Let's see. You're at level 3 with only 15% chance, but odd. Ten percent chance. Do I even bother? I don't know. I'll try once.
It doesn't really matter.
He's gonna get the one definite charge in before things go downhill. Yeah, I think I'm just gonna start attacking still.
Yeah, I would. If you happen to get infinite, awesome.
Now, do I have to not attack to get infinite, or is it... See, this is why I was just like, I should just,
You can attack to get infinite.
Okay, but, ouchie. Ouchie forever. Just,
the only thing that stops the death blow is,
Well, he went infinite.
The only thing that, that you can't infinite from is a death blow. Anything else works fine.
Let's Let's see. He'll get the guaranteed big charge in to go to full. And then we're just gonna keep going freaking river dance on this guy.
Yep.
This fight is deceptively slow because the fact that we can't death blow him is like.
Uh huh.
I have to death blow him, or attempt to, which is like whatever.
Yeah, that's all you have in Infinite.
That was a good stomp. Rico's so low on few, I'd love to get him to go off here.
You could just have him charge to trigger it, too.
It's true, but I also want to hurt this thing because it keeps hurting me. Okay, well, he's gone.
Done.
So, I just gotta deal with Rico having low fuel.
Yeah, which isn't bad.
Okay. Well, all the riffraff hath been dealt with.
Okay, so...
So now do we just say hello to our little friend?
Yeah, this guy's gonna hurt. He's got some big ass attacks.
Angel system? Yeah, well, not good.
He only has one angel attack. Everything else is ether based.
Okay. I'm debating on starting with a heal with Titan.
I would, in fact.
It just seemed like a good idea.
Yep. It might be worth it to build up to 3 on everybody.
Yeah.
I mean, definitely on Faye.
Oh, he's got sparkle fun. Attack. What did that do? I don't know.
Supposed to be able to inflict pilot confusion, but I think everyone avoided it.
No, easy. Easy fight.
Also, this is one of my favorite tracks in the game.
Yeah, I was going to say, it's a good song. I mean, the final boss has got to have a good song. That's just like, that's the rules.
You dick! Dick!
Did just show up. Hi, how's it going? Do you mind? Clearly not. Clearly he does not mind at all. Right, one more to go to 3, and then once I'm at 3, I think I'm gonna juice him up.
Yep, off your attack and go ham.
Yep. Rico is confused.
I think so. It's hard to tell.
Okay. Yeah, Rico's just kind of doing his own thing. Okay.
Time to juice the pig.
Sightings only got a 5% chance.
Level 3 death blow.
Level 3 death blow, you sure?
Yep.
Because I was also considering unconfusing Rico.
Eh, he'll figure it out.
Okay. $7,000.
Because in three turns, Faye might be able to end this.
Oh, if he doesn't have to stop to heal first. But we'll go in. We're juiced. Our pig is juiced. Kishin. I've taken him to space.
Punch, 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 punch.
That is, that's what we in the business call maximum damage.
Uh-huh.
Hey, Rico did figure it out.
Dude, you figured it out. Told you.
How'd you know?
I'm psychotic. I have that ESPN thing.
Well, if we're just doing level threes. I like how that animation doesn't even happen. It's just like, look, you did 7,000 damage. Be happy with it. Alright, you gotta stop hitting him. Because he doesn't want to stop hitting you.
You're still okay. Okay, maybe not. Do it. You bitch. Alright, heal.
they were, very, very adamant.
Let's take one more attack then, that's fine.
Okay.
Might want to have Rico charge a couple of turns. So we can afford to heal if needed.
Alright. Let's do another quick 10 grand. Easy fight? how's it going, Alabaster Knights?
Oh, they had one more hit to go.
See, Arduin, that's what I was thinking. I was like, that can't be it. Is there a phase two? It's probably a phase two. It's always a phase two. Close-up shot of the robo butt.
Robo Jesus butt. Oh, yeah. It's like dividing the Red Sea all over again.
It is. Go see a doctor.
Yeah, probably.
Look at him happily bounce. He's so excited. It's all hopped up on Mountain Dew. What happened? My gear won't budge anymore. So our modifier has ceased functioning. It's probably the reason why our gears can't move anymore. It's only a slight energy response coming from the core now. What about Ellie? What's happening to her inside of that thing?
Oh, she dead.
The new system's bind on her should have worn off now. So aren't we getting any kind of response? You don't think we hurt her in that battle, too? Faye, calm down. The sensors are picking up a response from the life within Deuce. It's probably Ellie. I love how nonchalant he is. He's just like, probably, I don't know. He's had that type of response like the last five things someone has asked Sight, and he's just like, probably.
He checked out after Kane died.
Ellie, can you hear me? Deuce is no longer active. It's all over. So come out of there. Show me your face. Who know? A phase two. Who could have foreseen this? What's going on? What's wrong? Now detecting a tremendous amount of energy coming from within Deuce. Seems as something that was sealed up until now has suddenly been freed and is growing enormously.
I'm detecting it with my eyes.
Couldn't be the wave existence.
Keep up, Art.
That's gotta be it. The wave existence was just freed from its cage of fleshy existence in Zohar. Probably attempting to return to the higher dimension that it originally came from. Which means this is the after effect of the dimensional shift? What do you mean, after effect? It's like a shockwave that's induced by the dimensional displacement. But so much energy. as much energy as unleashed here now. What'll happen, Doc? Tell us. This planet will be annihilated.
Suddenly, asteroid belt.
These numbers indicate that it has more than enough energy to take out a whole planet. What you mean? What you talking about, Willis? Can't be serious. We all fought so hard, only for this to happen? Yeah. Sucks, don't it? Isn't there anything we can do? Can't we stop the after effect? No, not really. Almost all machinery, including our gears, are out of commission due to Zohar being shut down. This time, there's nothing we could do. And to put it to you straight, this is the end for us. See, he really did check out. He's just like, eh, well, time to go. This is freaking stupid. How the hell could it end up like this? What were we all fighting for up till now? Vibrations are intensifying. Hold on a second. No, these vibrations are different. Has to be something else causing it. Look! Deuce is rising.
Oh my.
What's it this time? Deuce is releasing its remaining energy and is beginning to accelerate. If it continues to accelerate at this rate, it will soon leave the atmosphere. You don't think? Think what?
I love that Bart answered that. Bart's you don't like, think. Right.
Thinking? Is that Ellie? Ellie's moving Deuce. You sure? No, I'm totally sure of it because it makes me feel better about it. Ellie's trying to save us by moving a Deuce away from the planet. She's gonna sacrifice herself. That can't be. Oh, Ellie. Can't we do anything? Well, we can pull them back down here and then have everyone die. So, you know, there's that.
Ellie or Choo Choo? Decisions.
There's still something I could do. What?
Wait, we... Arduin, we pay Bart? Hold on.
I like how FaZe, like, my gear still works. Everyone else is like, we can't do anything because our gears don't work. Pudding's right there. Come on, Pudding. You can't say that you don't work.
She's on her mandatory break, so...
So you're saying that she doesn't work. Got it.
Union rules.
Well, that was
10 minutes every 2 hours. It just happened to be now.
Shame. Without Zohar, the power source for your gears, the only gear that now remains active is mine. Just like Deuce, my gear, and I made contact with Zohar. We're the only one who can move now. I'm gonna go save Ellie. You're stupid. Stop saying stupid things. If you're able to catch up to Deuce, you won't have enough energy to make it back. Even so, I gotta do it. Even if it doesn't make sense, you can't stop me. I'm not gonna stand by and let you commit double suicide if that's what you're planning.
That's not how that works, Bart.
He's like, I'll make it triple. He latches on.
Only the one Sudoku.
Better make it back alive, you hear? Promise me. Promise me and I'll let you go. He puts on an eye patch. I promise. So that way he can't see the wink. Wink. Look, now we're eye patch pros. I would never lie to an eye patch pro.
I'm telling Hammer. Wink. Hammer!
Now you're gonna have to yell louder than that for Hammer to hear you.
Hammer!
Promise you that I'll return with Ellie. You better. Of course. Okay, fine, go. Clinton's like, you guys are stupid. Stop being stupid. Brian's like, no. Hit Brian. Bart's like, let
Brian?
Have it. Yeah, Brian. Look, he's being a Brian right now. At this point, Faye's the only one that'll be able to bring Ellie back. Nothing we can say or do about it. We can just let Ellie die and be fine. It'd be cool.
We promised to miss her.
The both of you, come back home. We'll be waiting for you. As Pudding could also come with us if she wanted to, but, you know, that mandatory break.
You need rules, man.
I like how they're having this long conversation. I really need to hurry before they leave the atmosphere. But should you? Hold on. Let me give you my dissertation as to why I need to do this.
And now a dramatic reading of the transcript of the War of 1812.
This will be the last journey you and I make together. I'm counting on you, partner. Whee!
On to the story battle of destiny!
Actual answer is pudding that pudding is probably ether powered, which is also Zahar-saurus. But she's still big. She's got arms. She can swing.
8 minutes left of the break.
Ellie! How's it going, everybody? Just chilling in space.
I'm in space. Space. Want to go home, want to go home, want to go home.
Space! Oh. Now we're in the
Twilight
the
space
zone.
Anus.
The spanus?
The spanus, if you will.
I need passage through the devil's anus. But he's like, no.
Buy him dinner first? Question mark?
Has anyone watched Thor Ragnarok? It's a great movie.
Yeah.
Where am I? And why are we always naked? Is it tax time again? Ellie, does mean we're inside of Deuce? What the deuce? Hello, ghostly face.
Hi, ghost face, lady.
Your actual body is but a physical object. It has merely been absorbed into Deuce's outer shell. Only your consciousness is here. Of course, the girl you perceive in front of you is also not a true being. Your consciousness is merely creating her image.
And this weird ball thing.
Just what? The way of existence? No, that's not you. Who are you? Is that you, Krellian? Ah, jeez. Why can't I get rid of you? The path of Sephiroth has been connected. No one can stop God from returning to his world now. What have you come here for, Lacan? I came here to take Ellie back. I guess. Deuce's system's been destroyed. It's all over now. So instead I ask you, what are you hoping to achieve now? Time when all things started. The place where all things were one. I'm gonna return there. What place? Before the beginning of the universe, in an undulating waves of the higher dimension, all things were one.
You know, down at that Costco on 4th.
Oh, it's good times. It was the waves spilling out from there that created this four-dimensional universe of ours. Humankind and the souls of humankind that were born from there are merely leftovers of those spilled waves. So, you're going back there? Is that what you want? Khan, why such reluctance to become one with God? What attachment could you possibly have to this wretched old world? What meaning can be found in living out such a short existence, hurting others, hurting yourself, grinding one another down, only to inevitably die and return to dust? Everything we could desire is here. No need to be troubled by the need for love. This place is filled with the love of God. I've not lost hope in humans as much as you have, Krellian. Someday humankind will come to understand one another. I sincerely believe that. How can you be so sure? Humans will never come to understand each other. You said that she's the person you love. Can you say that you truly understand each other? All humans do is place themselves at a comfortable distance from each other and call that mutual understanding, spiritual unity, or true love, but it's all lies.
Yeah, man.
Men can't associate with others without first deceiving themselves. That's the way that they were created. But one being's ego can't determine everyone else's fate. People have the right to choose their own destiny. That's why humans have free will. Yada, yada, yada. And what if that will itself was predetermined? What then? Oh, what folly! Humans are just primitive life forms that have no such things as free will. Mankind has merely been allowed to live in an imperfect state, as is, as will be. As for this very reason, because humans have this wretched will or whatnot, humans must experience sadness and loss. Someone to gain something means another to lose it. It's impossible to make humankind share limited things and affections. So I came to the conclusion that everything must be reverted back to where it all began. Go back to where all was one, waves and nothing else. That's not my human's ego, that's the will of the waves, the will of God.
Very good, Krellian. Now stand still while these guys in the nice white coats give you a jacket that makes you hug yourself.
They're coming to take him away, haha.
Yow!
To the funny farm, where life is beautiful all the time. Well, that's alright too, we don't have to be perfect. Because being imperfect makes mankind live by helping each other. That's what being human is. That's mutual understanding. That's unity and love. I'm glad. No, proud to be human. Ellie placed the future, tomorrow, in our hands based on our choice, and she's working to keep Deuce far from our planet. It's also trying to heal your heart. You, who wants to journey all alone to be with God. Can't you understand Hilly's feelings? You have to become one with God before you're able to comprehend all this? I understand. I know her feelings as if they were my own. She and I are one, even though she's over there and I'm over here.
One divided by two, something, something.
Divided by zero.
Oh, no, that's what got us missed in the first place.
Well, then prove it to me. Show me this power of human. Show me this love that you say can make you independent of God. Oh. Naked fist fight final battle?
If only. If that was the case, can you imagine the fan art that would have come out of this game?
Fair enough. I'm back in my robot. Okay.
All right. The only tip I will give you for this fight is if he hits you with defense down, get rid of it. Test that. Have fun.
Well, we have a standard mode of attack here, which is just triple attack, power up, go nuts. Oh, there's the defense down.
You can let it stack up a couple of times. Just don't let it get out of hand.
Oh, is it a stacking thing?
Yeah.
Okay. No. Circle, circle, circle. I'll put my own defense down. That'll show him. Okay.
Punch him.
Take this, you weird angel snake thing. Okay, yeah, I think we can still keep rocking. This foot of mine glows with an awesome power. It tells me to defeat you. Burning toe jam.
No!
Look, I was talking about the Sega character Toe Jam from Toe Jam and Earl. Okay. Stacked it on me twice, I'll get rid of it.
Yeah, that definitely down to 40% loss. And now fine.
Oh.
Oh, the big attack, oh no.
Ow. Do I heal or do I keep rocking?
If he does it again, heal. You vastly outspeed this guy, so. But they're pretty good, you'll kill him before.
Oh. What did that do? Oh, that's just
that was rude. You can heal here if you want. That should put you into ultimate.
I was just thinking about doing my attack up again because I don't know how long they last. So I was just like, just.
I don't think you need it because I think Kishin just does 9999 anyway.
Oh, does it just always do 9999?
It might.
Punch, but punch, punch, punch.
Nickelodeon.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, well. I don't know if that's because I saw the buff or just because it always does 9999, but.
I don't think it matters much.
Well. There we go. Ellie. Everyone look away. Everyone's so indecent.
Bunny, close your eyes.
It was Krellian. Krellian released
Scott,
me.
Scott, you too. Hey, Xion.
How's it go, Xion? I came to understand after becoming one with Krellian. His heart
you
was so full of
cheating sex. Bitch!
We did taxes together. His heart was so full of sadness. That's why he desired for he and I to become one with God.
Here I am fighting to save the universe, and you're over there forming an LLC with Krellian. What the hell?
That would be the return to beginning and everything. He told me you should be with him. That's what he said. You see, he already knew. He already knew how I felt, how you felt. There's nothing he could do. There's no choice but to go forward, even if it meant he lost all feelings, all everything he had that was human. For all of humankind's sake, there's no going back. Even looking back held too many memories. And he would have just wanted to go back, even though he couldn't. So please forgive him. Clearly he loved people more than anyone else.
Well, of course he did. They were delicious.
Oh, yeah. Soylent Green is people. Somehow knew all along. I knew he was really that kind of person. I'm sorry. Please forgive me. I was wrong. I thought sacrificing myself in order to save others was the right thing to do. But my actions only brought sadness to all the people who I left behind, who would have inevitably died if I didn't do that thing. Why are you so stupid?
Details.
My sadness gave birth to even more sadness. As long as I still live with you, my life's not just mine alone. Ellie, shut up. Sacrifice yourself's a noble thing. If it were to benefit yourself, it's no problem. Always be a person healed, one or the other. Love gains its original shine only when there's an interrelationship between the giver and the receiver. It's incomplete when one or the other is missing. The two are one. It was you, Ellie, who taught me that. I believe that it is what it means to be human. I can now understand the importance of it. I don't know if it's the right answer or not. We have a lot of time to think about it. What Krellian himself was looking for all along. I'll find the answer to it all ourselves.
Thank you, Faye. Ellie.
Now for the 1040 easy.
Cutscenes.
What do you hear, friends?
Let's return to our planet.
Was that like the actual I must go, my planet needs me?
I must go back, my planet needs me.
Yeah.
Contact with our world, but the dimensional shift has already begun. Will we make it in time?
Can you run?
Not at all.
If we're together, I can.
Convenient shininess!
They knew what they were doing. Totally sounds like running.
There's no time to do our taxes in here.
Maybe if we file with H&R Block.
No, I can't run, as it turns out. I guess we'll just give up on running. We got Deus Ex Machina.
A great place to park a bike.
Krillian's like, I'm not ending this game without a sweet butt shot.
Now there is no more God. This is no longer.
That even sound dull.
This is your home planet that you are now standing on.
Dude, I'm so high right now.
You aren't going, are you?
No. Since that time, I have stopped being human. I've committed so many sins that any attempt at
one of those was Dan.
Human is impossible. The only one who could
that have one, giant head.
Is God.
Check that out.
That's not true.
Oh, more butt
I know
shots.
He would understand. There's still plenty of time to
20% more butt per butt.
All people could do it.
Always the peacemaker, eh, Lacan? Perhaps that's what it means to be human.
I love how they didn't try at all to match the dialogue with the lips.
I cannot go. It's something I've already decided. I go to walk with God. Even if there's no place left for me upon my return.
I mean, that or if you show up, we'll murder you.
I must go now.
This is all your fault, gestures around vaguely.
Krillian.
Oh. He was definitely full Ken doll there. Not that I looked.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, I envy you two.
Now I can fly on these sweet ass wings, peace bitches!
Later, nerds! Earth.
And back to space where it all began.
Space, the final frontier. Star date, I don't know nor care.
Two?
Started two. Space, the area between my ears, there's a lot of space there.
What happened? Who's the dude with the laptop?
Oh, it's Steve.
From the explosion disrupted the atmosphere,
making it impossible to get a visual. They were probably caught up in the explosion.
That's a lie.
Yes, that was Bart.
He'll come back. He promised us he would. I know it.
He promised. Phoenix has returned to see the end of the game.
So has Robot Jesus.
Hi, Pudding.
I'm convinced that's just Bunny.
How do I tell Satan that those glasses aren't big enough for his eyes?
Punch him.
Is this cutscene different if you don't make Emeralda bigger?
You know, I don't know. That's an excellent question.
I was like, because they have bigger Emeralda here, but as far as I'm aware, that's optional.
It's certainly missable. Which, like, that's why, like, when I was going through it, but when we were off stream the other day, I was like, how is this missable? This is important.
Oh, we got the sweet song. We did it! We hit the end credits! Easy.
Ta-da!
So I gotta say... we did it. So yeah. This game... there were... a lot of people being like, you need to get this and this and do all of this grinding. No grinding, no going out of my way, and I struggled even a little bit.
The only grinding I would say is required if you're not going to do any others is getting the speed shoes.
I think that made it easier, but that
makes such a huge difference in the later fights. Like, because you're going twice as fast is huge.
Yeah, but the boost mechanic exists. It's just at the cost of fuel.
Yeah.
So but, I think it would have made the end fights more difficult, but certainly not undoable.
One of them might have been undoable.
No, I don't think so.
Well, almost undoable.
I think it would have been harder.
Yeah, because you got to bear in mind, with tanks that big, your booster cost is also huge.
I don't know.
Like, you, between booster and Z, the fuel drain on the one aspect, your Z charger would not have been enough to keep up.
There would have been a lot of extra micromanagement and more thought process. Like I said, it would have been harder. But I don't think it would have been undoable. But I know people were like, you got to get like the super extra damage thing, and you're going to definitely have to grind for levels and money. And
nah.
The only thing we did was get those speed shoes, and even then I was like, okay, I guess I'll do that little thing. It was like a very small concession.
The only thing in the game that would require some grinding time would be to be able to take on the dragons on foot.
Yes.
And even then, like, you were close.
Yeah, and that's not necessary. That's just for better gear.
Right. Which has no impact on the final fights because you're in Gears all the time.
Correct. The gear doesn't matter because we're in Gears.
Yeah. like, you could have... Spending some time at the Kislev Arena could have been fun because there's some really cool, unique gear equipment and stuff you can get out of there.
Oh, absolutely.
But that, it, yeah, I think it's...
Like I said, if I was playing this game casually, like, not on a stream, I would probably do a lot more messing around and stuff like that.
Yeah, and like getting Faye high enough to see his last two death blows, because his last two are fucking phenomenally cool.
Yeah. Look, I got to see Saiten's last death blow pre-sword.
You did.
Oh, this was animated by Production IG?
Yeah.
They're that old? Because they still make good stuff today.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, they've been around a long time.
Want to see Fifi play Persona? I would also get a kick out of that.
Well, once my ridiculous traveling for the next couple of months is over, I'll see about getting my stream back up and running, and we can maybe make that happen.
Excellent. Animation production by B Train. I don't like that train.
I mean, I've seen the boys. I don't much like A Train either. Kind of a douchewad. Oh, sorry, I gotta go Jersey. He's kind of a douche.
Douche nazzle. So, with that, I'll be on a short break from long play RPGs, at least until I can think of another one that I want to do on stream. I think I might pick the next one as to just one I want to play. Because we did Legends of Dragoon, which was my pick. And then we did Vagrant Story, which was also my pick, but...
Yeah, but...
Because Scott,
of Scott's belligerency.
And look, it is an alright game. It's just like the ending broke me. So it's fine.
Lack of crossbow.
And then... this game was your pick. Now, go back to my pick.
So, like, aside from the development differences in Disc 2, as a whole, what do you think of the game?
As a whole, I think the game is all right. It's not completely my flavor. It's a little too... the plot strings get real convoluted. So it's hard to follow everything, and then they purposely like hide certain things, but then they say words to be like, but what about this? But then they don't tell you about it for like 3 hours. And like, it's all right. But I have to say, like, Disc 2 was rough.
Yeah, and like, I knew that was coming. The development team had no way to not do that. It was either when their funding got pulled to go to a mainstream Final Fantasy game. They were like, well, we can either scrap the game completely or we can do this to get the story out there.
Yeah.
Which, like, I'm glad they did. And because this game existed, the reboot started in the PS2 era.
Yeah.
Which, if they wouldn't have made the design, like, the combat design decisions in 2.
Did they Star Wars this? Episode 5?
Yes.
How dare they? Yes, they did. How dare they try to slip in a Star Wars at the end?
Yeah. So when Namco acquired the rights and restarted the Xenosaga, which was their original plan was to be all six games.
Mm-hmm.
because this is a 6-game story arc. They started at 1, and 1 was really well received. Then 2 came out, and they made some decisions in how combat works in 2 that pissed off most of the fans. Like, 2 is mean and stupid as far as combat goes. Story's still great, though. Because of that, like, they retconned the changes into 3, but because they lost so much momentum, 3 was going to be the last game. So they tried to wrap up as much post this game story as possible into 3, which they did an okay job. I think the Xenosaga games are definitely worth playing, and it's worth suffering through 2 to get the story continuity to go into 3. But playing 1 and 3 is a blast. Combat's so much more fluid. It gets psychotic. You can get to the point where the final bosses of 1 and 3 are both designed to be taken on in the gears. But if you know what you're doing, you can do it on foot, and it's hysterical to do.
I was thinking towards the end of this game, how much of this game you could theoretically do outside of Gears just forever. But mechanically speaking, I don't think it would be possible because there's so much platforming and this one you have can't. To do. And then, yeah, it probably doesn't let you get out of the gear in certain points.
Yeah, I mean, and it also, because of the way they did stat blocks in this one.
Yeah, it's just...
like, it doesn't matter how strong you are on foot. The stat blocks for Gears, their defense is just so fucking high.
Yeah.
And yes, in Xenosaga 1, 2, and 3, you get Cosmos, who is a lot of fun. You get Chaos, who is one of my favorite characters in this series to date. His name is actually Chaos, and he's silly. But you can utterly break the game with him. It's great.
Well, his name is Chaos. I would expect nothing less.
Yes. I think I know what my next pick will be, though. When it comes time for you to hit pick my brain.
Okay.
I'm thinking it's gonna be Rogue Galaxy time.
Rogue Galaxy. It's another one for which I am unfamiliar.
PS2.
Okay. I mean, PS2 had some solid games. You know what game I would love to play again? I only played through it once. I've said this many times, but it's very hard to play because they've never re-released it. And I don't own its original console anymore, and it's hard to play.
Which one?
It was in my brain as I was saying it, and then it lost.
After that build up, if you forget the name.
I have like half of it. Hold up. Google, don't fail me now. Lost Odyssey.
Because Xbox, original Xbox, wasn't it?
Xbox 360.
360? Yeah, I've never actually played that one.
And they've
but
never
that is one that I wanted
it.
To.
That game is so good. That game is so good.
Yeah, it was always on my list to play, but I never had a 360.
Like, it is so good, and they've never re-released the game. The only way to play it is to own the original copy of the game and play it on an Xbox 360. Like, which is infuriating because I want it.
Well, now that I think about it, though, if we want to go older retro...
I don't have a 360. I don't, not anymore. I used to, and then it red-ringed. Scott still has one.
I have an SNES game that... I kind of want to see someone else play through and beat sometime. Because it murdered me as a child.
Go on.
Lagoon.
Good old Lagoon.
Oh. I take it you're familiar?
Yes.
Oh, that last boss fight. Oh my god.
Good times.
I lost my mind so many times before I finally beat that fucker. Alternately, have you ever played Soul Blazer trilogy?
No, I've heard good things.
Soul Blazer, Illusion of Gaia, Terranigma.
The only reason why I've never played them is A, just opportunity, never got around to it.
That's fair.
And B, it looks like they play a lot like Secret of Mana games, and we played Secret of Mana on the channel, and I didn't care for it, so I was like, eh.
So the Soul Blazer itself plays much more like Zelda-esque.
Yeah.
Illusion of Gaia, I guess, would be a... I can't really go Secret of Mana though, because they're all very Zelda, or like Zelda 1 Link to the Past style.
Sure.
I personally have never played Terra Enigma, which is sad because I've heard nothing but great things about that game.
Another big RPG that I've never played that people have told me to play is the Suikoden, particularly 2. But
anyway, that's another one I've never touched.
Told they're good, so I might try to dabble in that at some point.
I've heard the same.
Suikoden 5 is good. I didn't even know they went up to 5.
Of course, if I really want to mess with your head, I'll sucker you into playing Galarian sometime.
Unfamiliar.
Oh, it's a... Resident Evil-esque, but it's all about brain fuckery. As opposed to like a virus.
Makes sense.
It's weird. I never beat it. Mainly because my copy got stolen. Well, kind of stolen. But yeah, it's trippy fucking game though. And it's a game where you can literally die by walking around if you're not careful.
I'll have to keep an eye out on that. I think for now I'm probably gonna end the stream because the game is over and I just saw my light flicker and it has been storming outside. So this might be divine providence. The game ended a little early. I'm gonna cut and run while I can, just in case the power goes out.
That is fair.
I don't know if anyone noticed. I was looking around halfway through that last sentence of yours. So I was just like, I saw the light flicker, and I went, okay.
Well, then, and that is one more retro game down and in the history books.
Hooray! So I hope everybody enjoyed it. We beat the game. We did it, as I knew we would. And I will end it there. And I hope everybody enjoyed it. I hope everybody has a good rest of their weekend. All that fun stuff. See you guys next time. Bye-bye.
Later.